I'm going to give you day two of staying at the Real República in Punta Cana, Dominican Republic. You know what I'm talking about. You know what I'm talking about. So basically, day two, man, I got turnt the night before. I got super turnt. So remember going to sleep, waking up, just chugging water. Start chugging water. That day, I don't think I went and ate breakfast. I think I literally just drank water, went down to the pool. When I tell you, the pool is amazing. Everybody's turned up, music playing. You have the ladies at the facility that work here. They're doing these little dances in the middle of like a cement slab going, cutting across the pool. And then you got like, I guess you call them pool bars in the water. And people are just drinking, sitting on the little pool bars, and these ladies are dancing. It was a good time. I was meeting people that were from Russia and Chile and Canada. It was really, to my surprise, not as many like American people, people from the US. It wasn't really many of them, like at all. It was a lot of Russian people. And also another thing I noticed on a resort, we kept running into people and they did not know English. Like they'll be dancing with us and having fun, and then we start talking to them. And they're like, "Oh, I don't know English," and we're like, "Wow!" So, running into that, then we went to the beach. It was fun. Went to the beach. It was really fun. People were friendly. Nice environment. Wasn't really people out there wilding out and partying and stuff, but it was people just chilling and stuff like that. But we kept going back to the beach periodically. Beach pool. But the pool, oh my goodness, turned up lit. After the pool, we took a shower, we went to eat. Then after we went to eat, we went to this bar, and yo, craziest story ever, I'm not making this up. We get to the bar, and me and my homies, we walk in, and like women just swarm to us. They're staring us down. Some women would come up to us, others would just stare very aggressively, just stare very aggressively. They'll come sit by us. But we had one particular girl, she came and sat by us. But we weren't paying her no mind because we already know the inside scoop out here. Like a lot of these women, 95% of them sell themselves, if you know what I mean. So we already knew what it was. They see us, they know we're not from here, they think we got money, we're rich, blah, blah, blah. So they try to get our attention. So the girl, she was sitting there, sitting there, sitting there. I was not paying her no mind because I didn't want nothing to do with her. Me and my friend paying her no mind. Next thing you know, I went to go get a drink. I come back. Then she sits there for a little bit, and then she sits at the table with us, and she starts talking to my friend. And it's like they plan everything together. Like soon as she says something to my friend, this girl just comes from behind me. She has a big BBL, big fake breasts. I'm not gonna lie, I thought she was a man at first. So she's talking to me and I'm looking at her hands the whole time. And I know she was probably like, "Why do you keep looking at my hands?" I'm just looking, I'm like. So long story short, it was weirding me out because I already knew they were trying to get us to pay for vagina, So I went to go get a drink. So I left my friend, I'm wrong for that. So as I went to go get a drink, I'm walking and there's these women, they're just lined up on the wall. Beautiful women. I'm gonna be honest with you. Like these are like women that you just don't see every day. But remember now, I'm not. I ain't really like the type of dude to just be thirsty like that. But these women had me like, wow. So they already see me looking at them. But I already know what it is. They're selling themselves. So I'm at the bar and people just coming up to me talking. "What up, man? What up?" Some of them knew English though. And they would just come up to me. It's like, I ain't gonna lie, I'm not trying to be funny, but I felt like a superstar. I mean, I'm not like boasting about it, but I already know that I'm in an area where I'm probably the wealthiest guy in the building. Just being honest, like, come on now. It's Dominican Republic. I've heard about these places, and plus you can tell how the community looks and stuff. They're in poverty out here, So I'm just in there like, whoa. Like, I'm like the guy in here. So this guy comes up to me. He's like, "Yo, what's up?" And I'm like, "What's up?" He's like, "Yo, I'm from Jersey." I said, why are you out here? He said, long story, long story. So I'm talking to him. And I'm like, so what you doing out here? And he was just laughing. And he pointed at the wall. And that was the same wall all them girls were lined up at. So basically, he was like a pimp. And he was there. I already peeped game. So what happens, they're there. They try to make friends with the tourists and get the tourists to pay for their women. You know, I already know game. It is what it is. So that's why he was trying to get me to pay for one of his girls. But I told him, I said, hey, I don't even have sex. But every time I told someone that, they were so shocked. It's almost like they were more drawn to me because they realized, like, I'm not really here trying to take anything from anybody. I just want to have a good time because they're so used to tourists coming. And, like, that's what they do. Go out, sleep with the women, do all that stuff. You know, that's what a lot of guys do when come here. And they see me, and I'm like, I'm not here for that. They're like, So the little pimp dude, it was funny. I was like, yo, the woman, and I remember the girl that came up to me and my friend. I remember I went to get a drink, and that's where I met the pimp dude. So I was like, yo, can you come with me and tell me if this lady's a woman or a man? I said the lady, because that's what she presented herself as. So he said, I got you, man. He started laughing. So he was like, where's she at? And I pointed, and she was at the table with my friend talking with her friend to him. So he was like, he looked. He's like, nah, man, that's a woman. I was like, cool. So I go back to the table, and they just start dancing on us. Just dancing, like, I've never had a BBL in my face. This is the first time I had a BBL in my face, and I'm like, I mean, it felt weird, but, I mean, it was just an interesting experience, and by any, I was not attracted to this woman, by any means necessary, I was not attracted to this woman, like, not at all. Literally, it was just like, no, but it was interesting, because I never had boobs and butt that big, so, long story short, she's trying to get me to pay for sex. I'm like, no, I'm not here for that, I'm just having a good time. Just having a good time. And that just kept happening over and over and over. I'm like, yo, it's crazy because even the most beautiful women there are selling vagina. The pimp straight up told me, I was being funny with him. I was like, yo, I ain't having sex enough, so I don't want none of your girls. I was like, you know, but I'm looking for a wife. He said, brother, you're not going to find a wife here. He said 95% of these women here sell their bodies. And I believe it. I believe it. This is the norm. This is just literally the norm. So I was like, all right, bet. So I went back, danced with chick. Long story short, I ended up leaving the bar. She was trying so hard. She was trying so hard to get me, but I didn't want it. But before, I forgot to tell you, before I went into the club, like, these little kids were coming up to me with bracelets and stuff. And I'm not going to lie, I gave one kid a dollar. You know, it's just a dollar. So to me, it's nothing. Because, you know, I'm just being nice. I'm like, I have a kind heart, you know, and they're kids. I have a soft spot for kids, so I was giving dollars. Next thing you know, I'm like, okay, that was four of y'all came up here for a dollar, and I just had, at a point, you have to say no. It sucks, but you just have to say no, because if not, you'll go broke, because they're, all of these people here are begging, and I get it. I completely get it. Like, wouldn't you do that to survive? Wouldn't you do that to eat? So I didn't really judge them, but that was day two. Crazy. I know, I'm sorry if I was scattered and everything. I had a long night. I just want to get this material off before I completely forget. But day three coming soon.